fifth, an RBI double in the sixth to right. That was not hit hard. High chop off the plate. Dominguez takes a look at Beltre. He's got him in a rundown. And he throws to Altuve. And Altuve will flip to the shortstop, Elmore. Beltre's going to wind up in Bel Air. And he is out number one with Rios on at first.
This Little League moment will continue right after this.
Top of the fourth inning here at Target Field this afternoon. Tigers have a 4-0 lead in this one. Now what's going on in the dugout? Some hijinks? Don Kelly's foot is on fire.
Where's Bert Blyleven at?
Oh my goodness, he still doesn't know.
That's terrible.
Hey, by the way, Don, your foot's on fire. Oh my goodness. Now that's beautiful.
Comes back 92 on the fastball.
Dick, somebody got Jerko with the old gum and the cup on top of the hat. Oh, that's the oldest trick in the book. That and the old hot foot. You know what the key though is? You got to try to put water in there. So when he tilts his head, water comes out. He's like, where's that water coming from?
Ground ball to short. Amarista in between hop. And a 1-2-3 inning for Kevin Quackenbush. Stretch half of the seventh at Petco. It's number 13 on the list of rules in the clubhouse. Always well your cup. And Jed Jerko bringing some smiles.
Even pitching coach Darren Walsley likes it. Jose Valentin is trying to score 2 points.
Tyler Field in Chicago. David Ortiz leading it off. And a bunt bid. Garcia off the mound to Field and throw. And it's time to get Ortiz. Shift was on, and David tried to drop down third baseline, but really back towards the mound, and he's out number one.
Yeah, Big Poppy making his bid to become the Red Sox leadoff hitter next season. As he tries to drop one down that third baseline, but couldn't get it down the line enough. Right back to Garcia, and Garcia says, thank you very much.
This one fouled off, and he and Ozzie had a good time afterwards. And Ozzie was all over him.
Expected to be Friday as the A's will not have an off day before the Angels come to town.
It's hit well to center. Yadi's back. He's at the wall and he leaps up and he makes the catch. He had enough time to get back. He timed his jump perfectly. And he took one back.
Well, and Colon, a few more choice words for it. Pujols as he ran back.
Well, Trevor Bauer's third at bat of the night. He might be under orders. Do not swing.
Yeah. You know, this is, you go back and you talked about it earlier. This was what it was like.
He's calling the Mike Avilas. Oh, my goodness. That is outstanding.
Yes, he did. I don't know if Andre saw, but he just did.
He swings and fouls it back.
I think he wanted to go deep.
Now the guys in the dugout are catching on. They're all going to the, they want to go, they want to see more of this.
Look at it.
Oh, he's got it going.
Look at Avilas smiling. He's loving it. He's critiquing him is what he's doing right now.
Not quite as good as Mike, but not bad.
Well,
now he goes back to the Kip. The man of a thousand stances. Who did they used to call? The 0-2. Swing and a foul. Let's see what he comes up with this time.
This is a Trevor Bauer. He's tried those.
That's Rayburn. He's doing Rayburn.
Yeah, he did.
This is great. Low and away.
He took it for a ball. He's incorporated three different batting stances in this at bat.
Well, apparently, the catcher tonight for the Tampa Bay Rays, Jose Molina, there's a guy named Yadi that knows him pretty well. That's his brother. And our guess is he likes cheese crackers because look at this.
That's Jose Oquendo going out to coach third base. Left a snack right on home plate for Jose Molina, and Yadi just loves it. And my favorite part of it is Jose just looked over at the Cardinals bench, laughed about it. There's the cheese cracker sitting right on home plate. ends up kind of ultimately picking them up and just putting them in his back pocket, and that's where they are right now, in Jose Molina's back pocket.
Welcome back to Busch Stadium. Just moments away from the opening pitch, but about 12 minutes and counting into the standoff between Scott Van Slyke of the Dodgers and Joe Kelly of the Cardinals, both remaining in their positions from the national anthem, having a major standoff to see who will break first. I talked to Don Mattingly to see if the two knew each other, or perhaps they had a side bet, and Don Mattingly said to me, and I quote, "Listen, you can't talk to the guards at the Buckingham Palace. Leave them alone."
We've been watching this now, and it continues even as the Cardinals have taken the field on the standoff. It continues. I don't believe we'll start the game with this still going on.
Joe Kelly's got to back down first. He's further out there.
I'm still trying to figure out, as an analyst, how do you prepare for that? What comments do we, what stats do we put to the standoff?
You know, there's been some stuff going on. The Dodgers have put a padding helmet on Scott Van Slyke. Joe Kelly, that was a bluff.
Now the, you know, when a stare down, a blink even gets you out of the game.
And we are just about set to go, I think.
It's not fair, though. One's on the grass line and one's close to the dugout.
Greg Gibson, the home plate umpire, motioning to both players. And the Dodgers celebrating in their dugout. Wow, what a bizarre start to game six. We talk about a lot of things in our production meetings going into this, but that wasn't on there.
Boxers marking their turf. Game
Baker
on.
Responding.
Game on.
We will keep you up to date. You challenge John Baker, and this is what you get. Although, is he using the right end of the U to form the B? He separated the U and the B. That's well done. And doing it, obviously, in reverse from behind.
He didn't like the way that S was laid out. He's tweaking it a little bit.
Well, boys will be boys. A hot foot has been scheduled. Whose cue was that? Oh, that's Scott Van Slyke. Okay. Little does he know. Remember, he got kicked out the other night for arguing about third strike call. We shall await further developments. Oh, look out here. Ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. Ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. Ba-dum. Nada. The whole bench is waiting for Scott Van Slyke. Well, Adrian certainly set it on fire. It took a while before Scotty reacted. And the first thing he does, something smells wrong in here. What is it that smells? Is anything wrong with my hat? There's something rotten in Denmark. What, maybe it's my hand. No? Now we found it. So needless to say, the Dodgers are playing pranks. They are not only leading 6-0, they're well aware the fact, as the bench breaks up, that the Giants are losing at least 3-0.
Record, but
Bartolo's got to get a new lid. I mean, the lid doesn't fit. Every time he swings, puts a lot into it.
I think the problem is how far he's trying to reach from his position in the batter's box.
I mean, not, you usually don't get a lot of cheers for a foul ball, but Bartolo does.
Well, he's already hit one fair ball today, grounded out to third base. He's very amused by the whole thing. Hits a tapper back to Morris, and again Bartolo carries the bat with him. Has he made it to first base yet this year?
I don't think he's gotten all the way there, but he's close. He's close. He's making it about 78 feet. And then once he gets there, it takes a little tail to the right and then shuts it down.
And ground ball behind the bag at third, but it's foul. Beltre throwing to Gary Pettis.
Well, he kind of put the pressure on Gary Pettis. Gary didn't want to catch it, but he's got to pick it up now.
This man always has fun at the ballpark, cheering on his teammates. He's fun to watch when he's pitching. He's smiling, joking around. He's energy with this club.
Like we said, he's really matured. But you're right. I mean, he's all business now when the day he pitches, but he's the number one cheerleader on the other days.
I think Carlos is pretty concerned that Waka and that right foot may just edge its way. Yeah, right, yeah. There. Edge its way over and knock it over. Uh-huh.
There it comes.
Better watch it, Carlo. Oh! Better watch it.
Ground ball. Bogarts will go to third and put the tag on Melky Cabrera, and he might have stepped on Cabrera's hand. Then Reyes has given him all kinds of grief. Who taught you how to slide like that?
Yeah. Where did you learn that? And he said, okay, I've had enough of that. Go out into your position and play. And he's like still ribbing him, and Melky says, all right, I've had enough of you. Now get back to shortstop now. Leave me alone.
Cardinals a loose bunch here in game four. One of LA's finest.
Hello, Fox Sports.
I love you, George.
Hey, man.
George, I love you.
Okay, you gotta announce that.
You're looking for any reason not to talk to me, aren't you, cuz? Talk to me, cuz. Talk to me, baby. Give me a hug. Give me a hug.
Come on, man. Agitate the gravel. I think I'll arch. Maybe get out of my chair, arch.
Gas him! Gas him! Woo! 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 Gas team!
Rangers maintaining their 5-3 lead. Adrian Beltre after chasing away Elvis Andrus on that pop-up.
They pretty much have a running dialogue the whole game.
Yeah.
And between innings, I don't know what Elvis said to him, but he said something, then ran away. Adrian threw his glove at him between innings, hit him in the back. The umpire just started laughing like crazy out there. Well, who's the second base umpire? Jim Joyce. Oh, you missed it. He was just about ready to fire the glove at him. Watch, here it comes.